All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Peter Clausi. He is the Vice President of Capital Markets for Silver Bullet Mines. And Peter, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Nice to see you, Steve.
So last time you and I talked, you had mentioned that through some work you had done around the Buckeye Silver Mine, you were able to sort of detect some extra minerals. And so maybe sort of take us back and talk about that part of it first before we get into today's news.
Sure. We got the mine up and running. We built a mill and it was functioning perfectly. So we moved from the lower grade material to the higher grade material. At that time, we got an order for silver in doré bars. We tried to pour doré bars from the higher grade material and we couldn't get them smelted correctly. If you look at the press release, they're black and ugly and malformed. And the science team figured out that's because we had elements in it other than silver and gold. So they sent samples out to a third-party lab for a broad spectrum analysis, and it came back with elevated values for palladium, platinum, rhodium, and osmium, together with high-grade gold.
So explain to us why this is so significant, especially with the other metals that you're talking about.
Well, as best we can tell, there is no palladium mine in Arizona. There is one source of palladium in the United States, and that's at Stillwater in Montana. So from an infrastructure point of view and national security, if this proves up, this is incredible news for the United States and the supply chain for critical minerals. The USA needs more platinum, it needs more palladium, it needs rhodium, it needs osmium. All of these things are part of a green economy. And the fact that we have found them is astonishing.
So let's talk about the news release today, because you've talked about sort of taking the next steps now. So what are those steps? Spell them out for everyone.
Well, the first step was to make sure that the first set of results from a 200-ton concentrate was not a fluke. So the science team went to work on 40 different samples, carefully mapped out to be as representative of the host rock as possible. It wasn't just go out and grab that chunk of rock. It's grab 8 chunks of rock from that area, blend them into a sample, and then test the resulting sample. Same thing with the muck pile and the tailings. We got them to be as representative as possible. And the numbers that came back are just astonishing. Like, you've seen gold mines run in 2, 3, and 4 grams of gold per ton. We're averaging over an ounce of gold per ton. And that's just the gold. Mm-hmm. So what this means for us on a micro basis is the gross economic value of every ton of ore we mill has shot up logarithmically.
So what do you do now moving forward? Will you continue to try and do more science around what's going on there? Or are you actually now going to start to try and gather some of those metals that you're getting?
Both. Science never ends, right? We have metallurgists and geologists and engineers working on the problem. The technology of separating palladium and rhodium, that's easy. I'm told that that exists. It's not a problem. The hard part is figure out how to bolt that technology onto our existing mill as quickly as possible for the greatest recoveries possible. So that science continues. While we're Steve, go ahead.
I was just going to say, so you've engaged a third party in order to help you do that, correct?
A few third parties.
Yeah.
And at the same time, we continue to take samples from all around the mine, all around the mill, because you can never have too many assay samples. You can never have too much data.
All right. Well, it'd be interesting to see how this all, what sort of timeline are you putting around this as long as it takes, or what's the sort of, what can investors expect?
Yeah, it's not going to be a multi-year process. It's going to be much shorter than that because the science already exists. To pull the rhodium and the palladium out of the host rock. This is figuring out how to bolt the pieces together, and that's a much quicker exercise.
All right, we'll leave it there. Peter, thank you so much. Very exciting, and look forward to continuing to follow the story as it develops. So appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you. Always nice to speak with you.
All right, there's Peter Clausi. He's the Vice President of Capital Markets for Silver Bullet Mines.